Today, what we're going to do is Roman chair bent leg raises. Why? Because we're going to focus on the lower abs. We're trying to keep everything tight in here. Most of us have that problem right down here, and we want to work it hard. Here we go. Ready? We're trying to keep all the tension where? Here, on the lower abs. Knees are slightly bent, back against the pad, and we're breathing in and out. Make sure you exhale as you go up. Inhale when your legs come down. Nice. Ready? Stop. If you notice, all the tension was applied to where? Lower abs. Now we're going to do an advanced version. We're going to keep the legs straight, back against the pad, and you're going to move it up and down the same manner. Now, we also can add weight to make it even tougher. It gets tougher and it makes the abs stand out a little bit more. We're going to do cable rope crunches. We're going to pull and contract into the upper abs, squeezing, blowing the air out, coming up very slow, nice and consistent, trying to focus on nothing but the upper abs and the upper obliques. All right, a lot of people stand close, but we're going to stand back about 1 to 2 feet, back straight, hands in the position to pull. Ready? Crunch it over, contracting where? Upper abs, upper obliques. Anywhere from 12 to 15 reps. A slight variation, but more advanced technique is sitting on the floor. They'll sit the same, about maybe a foot away. It's more of a concentration here. Everything is concentrated on here. What? The crunch is right there in the center. Less movement, more concentrated. Now we're gonna do the Russian twist, or better known as what? The windshield wiper. We're gonna lie on the floor. We have our feet. Feet are gonna go straight up. Now we're gonna swing from side to side, only moving the hips. Good, pausing in the center, dropping it all the way over. You never touch the floor, you only move from side to side. There you go, good. Blow it out, ready? That's it, contract as you get there. Come on, pause it, drop. Good, perfect. Now for the advanced version, we're gonna do a hanging version. You wanna get your body what? In a 45 degree angle, you're gonna move from side to side. Same procedure, don't lose that. Staying tight, not turning the torso, but only moving the hips. What we're gonna do is cable side crunch. All we're working is the obliques. What we're gonna do, get the arm in a 90 degree angle, drive the elbow down to the knee, pausing at the bottom, and releasing. Locking everything in, so why? It just doesn't fly up. Keep that motion going. Make sure you stretch from the obliques. Here we go. Ready? Blowing the air out. There you go. Squeeze. That's it. Holding that form. Nice, slow tempo. That's it. Anywhere from 15 to 20 reps. A more advanced version of the same thing. Elbow still in a 90 degree. Concentrating on what? Contracting in, lifting the leg off the floor to meet. Also, twist that body just a hair so you can get that nice compact feel. Now we're gonna go decline crunch. What we're gonna do, we're gonna sit on the bench, face up, grabbing the handle, and then all we're gonna do is make sure we get our glutes off the pad, bringing our knees toward the face. All right, ready, bring it up. Good, that's it. You notice how he brings it and he lifts, making sure those glutes come off the pad. There you go. Good, perfect. Bring it up, push, good. Make sure everything is medium weight. Don't go real fast. If you go too fast, what happens? You end up losing it and you put more pressure on your upper abs. Now we're gonna do the advanced version. Lie back in the same position, but you're gonna try to keep the movement going. And you're not gonna bring your knees to your face, but you're gonna bring them halfway in, but push back out. So you always stand up in the air, extending out. You're gonna do the wood chopper. What this is you're reaching across. Your arms are perfectly straight, going across the body. As you turn, your feet are staggered. You're reaching all the way across. Completion, pausing the exercise. Here we go. Ready? Don't move those hips, only move the upper torso. Ready? Good, there you go. When you move just the upper torso, what happens? All works there, obliques. If you notice, he's watching his arm movement. That way your body stays perfect. There you go, good. Exhale, good. We have two slight variations of the wood chopper. It's more of an advanced movement, one starting from the top, going down, and the other one from the bottom, going up. A lot of people try to use their arms to pull, but it's not that. You lock in position, and you still move it down. You notice only what? The torso is moving, not the hips. They're locked in place. Good.
I was gonna ask also about, talking about abs. I know you always talk about doing things to keep the waist small. So I've heard a lot of people now saying like they don't do obliques and stuff like that. Like how do you stand as far as working abs and stuff like that, but not doing things to kind of widen that muscle there in the waist area?
Obliques are muscle. Yeah. And once it gets thick and it's there, it's there. It's not going anywhere. I don't care what you do, you're going to have that oblique. So it's best not to do all those heavy weighted twisters and all that.
I've seen people with 45 days.
Yeah, that's the worst thing you can do because it's going to thicken you up.
And
when you get on stage, first thing that shows up are those obliques. Yeah, so stay away from it. I like just doing twisters, you know, with no weight, and that helps my waist a lot.